So I guess the way I'll do this. How should we do this? So the idea is you choose it's a MovieBob quote or not, you know, like a Nazi quote, and should it be like a vote between the all of us here? Like,
Kind of vote for
or should me and Rags not even necessarily be involved in it because we know a lot of them? I don't know.
Okay.
If you know
if
it,
we already know them, then you
shouldn't
say anything.
Well, if we know it, we can just excuse ourselves from the
You hiccup at me.
Shut the fuck up.
Called MovieBob or Nazi slash Neo-Nazi 4.0, the finale. This quiz
All
was made
right.
for the EFAP podcast, so if you do not watch it, most of the jokes will not make sense. However, the quiz is still fully functional as a demonstration of how insane MovieBob is. I'm sorry not giving sources for these quotes because I only thought about doing it halfway through making the quiz. However, all of the MovieBob quotes are sourced from his Twitter. The Nazi
Oh.
quotes have primarily been sourced from Mein Kampf and the Daily Stormer. Hi Wags.
Okay, that's the place to get them.
Hello, all my N-words. This quiz will test the limits of your massive intelligence. Even the great spider oracles had trouble divining the correct answers. Wow, it's really hard to tell the difference between these quotes, Adolf Hitler. I plan. I plan on making a condensed quiz based on the best questions from this quiz once I get around to 200 and 300 responses. I would make the condensed quiz at that point. We can just do this one. So these are instructions, I guess. The way this quiz works is you'll be given a quote. You have to decide if it is a Nazi quote or a MovieBob quote. You have to do this for a total of 100 quotes. The Nazi quotes could be from any Nazi, from the original funny mustache man himself, or the edgy book to whatever tism stuff I could find on Richard Spence's Twitter. Also, I remove some of the words that make it obvious who the quote is from. I will censor the obvious word by putting theme in the censored words place. Some examples of these potential words would be Jew, Germany, or Nazi. Additionally, I had to fix the grammar of MovieBob's quotes. If I didn't, you could just choose the quotes that were crimes against the English language and get all the correct answers. Finally, I updated some of the language in the quick Hitler quotes because they use words that no one uses anymore. With the instructions out of the way, please enjoy this quiz brought to you by Adam Hilt. Also, Mola, after you take the quiz, I can send you the statistics for the quiz on Discord. Sure,
Who
I'd be
is Adam
interested to
Hilt?
know.
I recognize him from Twitter.
I'm not gonna lie, MovieBob looks more like a war criminal than Hitler. Who did you genetics better? Drill Sergeant Bobby is gonna chew out the new recruits. Alright, so I guess the way I'll do this then is I read out the quote, and then a vote takes place, and I guess we'll make it J Dust Bullshit, and Mel can vote on it, and
Okay.
like I said, me and Rags will probably only come in if we actually do not know. We can let people know ahead of time. So
Also, if you don't know the quote, it might be a good indicator. I'm not read my.
actually,
Okay.
the problem is the
Like,
first one. I think
if
everyone
you
knows
don't
this
know the
one.
quote, it might be an indicator that it's a Nazi one. So, what's the first one?
The first one is, "I'll never forgive the troglodytes that who stole the
Oh,
future I earned to prolong their worthless existence."
yeah, I remember that one. That's definitely
Yeah,
Bob.
All right,
that's
we all know
Bob.
it's Bob.
That's Bob.
Okay.
Plus, Hitler never used the term troglodyte anyway, so.
Yeah, but they said they updated the language.
Maybe they did. You don't know.
Hitler didn't say it. He spoke German.
All right. Quote two. "I think that human beings, if you talk about our differences in terms of talent or intelligence or any other area, that doesn't necessarily make an individual human being inferior or a race inferior."
Uh-oh, that one's harder.
We can hear that
That's harder,
again.
yeah.
I will
Okay.
post them to you guys so you can read them as well.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think Nazi.
Yeah, I'm thinking Nazi on that one.
Well,
All
I'm
right, I'm
gonna
here. What one?
the one I just posted in
Doesn't sound like
chat.
something Bob would say, but it doesn't sound like something a Nazi would say either. Surely Nazis think a race is inferior. That's like their whole deal.
What say that say I think the human beings let me see. I think that's Movie Bob.
No,
I
because
think th this
no.
is what Movie Bob would say right before a big but.
Yeah. No, I think this is a Nazi because they're operating from, it sounds like they're operating from a perspective where you would expect a race to be inferior. They're saying, no, I don't necessarily think a race is inferior. I just don't like the people, all of the people of that race.
I actually think I read that quote before, and I think it's from Hitler himself.
You see?
Well, I'm going to abstain from the entire quiz because I'm enjoying just being the one who reads them out. We'll do it by votes, and if there's a tie, I'll be the decider.
I think it's kind of expected of you that you participate in this.
Well, I can reveal my vote at the end of each one. No, I don't.
Oh, he does?
No, I don't. But,
Mahler does.
I was actually stuck on this one until Metal said what he said, so I'm assuming it's a Hitler quote now.
I mean, don't quote me on that. I think I did.
Don't quote you on the quote? I'm quoting you.
I don't know mine by heart.
Fine. I would go with Nazi because I actually don't know the origin for this one for sure. What about everyone else?
Right.
Nazi.
Yeah, it's Nazi for sure.
Well, that's three, so that's good enough.
Okay.
All American politics of my lifetime have been about backwards people wedded to an inferior present, trying to prevent a superior future. I'm almost certain this is Bob.
Bob. Yeah, so wait a minute. For Bobby.
Do we not get the answer to that last one?
Not yet, no. You have to answer them all first.
Okay, so that third one, let me read that one more time. I think it's human being. Wait, can you post that other one, the third one?
Wait, sorry, you want to...
Third, the one you just read, could you post that?
Well, I'm starting to... Maybe we should do this to make it more interesting. You should actually go with your gut so we can get through it quickly and we'll see how funny the answers turn out to be. Because the more you think about it, the more it should become clear.
Okay, so read that one more time then.
It's in chat.
All American politics of my lifetime have been about backwards people wedded to an inferior present trying to prevent a superior future. I am so very, very tired of being denied a better world because of the small visions and smaller minds affecting so much of humanity.
That's
so,
that's definitely
honestly,
Bob.
Yeah, my vote is Movie Bob, but I could, it's such a, like, a Nazi could totally say it.
Yeah, but it's totally Bob.
But, like, I don't, it's because it's about America as well.
Yeah.
I think that's Bob.
If it said German, then I'd be like, Oh, but he didn't. Wait, to be fair, didn't he say that he was getting some Richard Spencer and people?
Okay. So this is why it's interesting. Shit. But we're locked in. All right.
I'm still going with Bob. I can't go back. It's Bob.
Richard Spencer. Code 4. Instruction in world history in the so-called high schools is even today in a very sorry condition. Few teachers understand that the study of history can never be to learn historical dates and events by heart. But what matters is not whether the child knows exactly when this battle or that was fought, when a general was born, or even when a monarch was coronated. To learn history means to seek and find the forces which are the causes leading to the effects which we subsequently perceive as historical events.
Nazi.
Yeah, that's a Nazi.
That's too eloquent for Bob.
I was going to say, I'm voting for the Nazi.
And not as venomous sounding as Bob.
Like that's like a pretty smart thing, and it's the kind of thing that where like being a Nazi wouldn't inform your perspective like that.
Yeah, so. I just don't think Bob would have been able to say it.
Yeah, and there's also too much punctuation. That's not Bob.
Sophistic Autistics wants me to tell you, Jay, that your comment's been deleted on the Objectivity video. I'm assuming it's just not visible. We can't know for sure it's been deleted, but maybe.
Oh my god, my comment. You know what my comment was? It was literally just, I don't think this video is very good. Deleted that.
Wow, deleted.
Deleted that.
Wow,
holy
what
shit,
a faggot.
Man.
What a little thin-skinned bitch.
That's racist. You can't say that about thin-skinned bitches. At some point, you have to choose to be a party to meaningful societal evolution and accept that not everyone is going to follow you into the future. Some will choose to remain backward and left behind.
Bob.
That's Bob.
I was going to say, I'm leaning to Bob. All right. When intelligent members of society become unable to overrule the ignorant, society falls.
That's Bob.
Bob.
I'm willing to go either way on that one. It's definitely in line with Bob, but
Then again, there was a little far too few words in that.
Can you paste it in the chat?
I can. Just go with the gut feeling. We have like.
Well, yeah, I was gonna say we gotta keep it going otherwise.
Oh, we got quite a few to go. Nice. All right. Yeah. So I'm sticking with Bob.
Oh, that could. I think that's Blob, yeah. It's quite eloquent for him, though.
All right, I think that's enough votes for Blob, then, is it?
Mm-hmm.
All right. There is forward and there is backward, superior future and inferior past, the evolved and the intelligent versus the ignorant and small-minded.
That's an,
It's like, I thought it was Nazi at first, but then he started using small-minded, and I'm like, okay, that sounds awfully Blob right there. I'm a little torn on this one.
I think I would go with Blob, but I think we started to reveal the point of why this was made.
Now we're starting to think about this shit.
I said Nazi.
Alright, I'm gonna go with Blob. What have you three
okay.
got? Gotta hurry.
I'm gonna go with Nazi.
Uh-huh.
I'm gonna go, you know what? I'm going with Blob.
Jay, it's down to you.
Blob.
Alright. There are times when I really hate that Jim Crow era laws ruined the idea of intelligence testing for voting.
Oh, Blob.
Okay, that's Blob. That's Blob.
We must
I'm
become
stupid. I don't know what Jim Crow era laws are, so I'll just
I almost think I've read that tweet from him.
It's old race laws in the US, old ones.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Okay.
We must become revolutionaries. We must bypass or shatter existing institutions and make them anew. The sellouts who can constitute the old elite must be removed forever. We must constitute a new elite, a daunting goal, perhaps, but the only goal that makes sense.
Mm-hmm, that's a Nazi.
I'm going with Nazi, yeah. Sounds too good to be Blob. Like, the way it's written.
Yeah.
This is
like,
more of,
again, I think I'll go with that too,
so much more of this is grammar rather than content.
Yeah, again, there's just too much punctuation for there to be Blob.
What does that tell you? Blob, you need to. This shouldn't be a possibility that we're doing this right now.
It's like it's not as damning as it could be because so far they've all just been. We need to like reorganize society. Like, yeah, some of them are kind of bad, but
I don't know. Like, I think some of them are pretty bad.
Some of them are pretty bad, but like,
yeah,
it's not as damning as it could be when you hear the phrase. Did he say this or did a Nazi say it? Like, you could get a lot worse.
Ask them to defend themselves, give them that opportunity, they will give you nothing because they have nothing. These are the faces of evil.
That's
so hard.
I'm aiming
that
to Nazi.
One's tough.
That's really tough.
Wow,
that one's tough.
It is tough, but
it's, no, it's too eloquent. It's a Nazi.
It's gotta be a Nazi.
That's four votes for Nazi, okay.
Yeah, we can go with Nazi on that one.
I don't see any moral difference between a suicide bomber and somebody in an F-16 fighter jet who fires a missile into an apartment complex and then kills 10 to 15 little girls and boys.
So because F-16s weren't around during the 40s... Yeah.
No. Rags. Some of them were Richard Spencer quotes.
Yeah.
Oh,
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
That's true.
Probably Blob.
I don't see much difference there. In fact, I think the pilot is a greater offender. He's getting medals while the suicide bomber is sacrificing his life for what he believes in.
Oh, God.
Oh, no, that's suspiciously close.
That's probably Blob. I'm just saying.
Oh, my goodness.
You know what? I'm willing to be wrong on this. I'm actually going to go with Nazi, but I could understand.
First time I was like, you know, that's like, first time I was like, I mean, I, you know, I
can't.
Yeah,
that sounds like something Richard Spencer would say.
The crazy thing is that I feel like that slots in perfectly with what I've seen from Blob before.
Yeah.
Going with Blob.
I think it's.
All right, we'll go
Nazi.
With Blob on that one.
Okay.
Well, I voted Nazi, so what's Jay and Metal going with?
I'm Nazi.
Well, because I'm on the fence. I thought you guys were all going Blob, because I think that's definitely something Richard Spencer.
Nazi then?
Well, if
it's 50-50. Like,
do we gotta flip a coin?
No, it's not 50. If Rags abstains, we've got two for Nazi, one for Blob so far. Oh, you're going Nazi.
I'm saying for me, it's like 50-50 for me. Like, I have no fucking
going. I could be wrong on this. So it's still down to Metal then.
Nazi. I just don't know. Just say Nazi.
So we're going with Nazi then, huh?
I think it's Blob. I think it's Blob. But whatever.
Really? Shit. It's a hard one.
Wait, so
I feel like a Nazi is less like people in the Middle East getting killed than Blob is.
Why? Who do you think the Muslims sided with in the 40s?
No, this is modern day Rags.
It could be a Nazi or Richard Spencer.
Yeah, I think it's Blob.
And I think Richard Spencer is very much a non-interventionist type.
Wait, so what is the final vote on that then?
Do we flip a coin?
No, well, we don't need to.
I said Bob.
I said Nazi.
I said Bob.
What did I say? I think I said Bob.
I think you said Nazi.
Okay. If I said Nazi, you said... Yeah, so we got three Nazis at least, right? So it's Nazi. Okay, fine. Okay, I'm just trying to move on.
No one's Nazi. I'm curious to see how that one turns out.
Here's something you should know about me. I believe that there is almost no such thing as a bad tactic, only bad targets. I know who said that.
That was Bob.
Sounds like Bob.
It's pretty Bob. Going with Bob.
Once we stop rejecting the basic truths of the universe and instead reject theme... Oh. Our civilization... Uh-oh. Will be 100 times more efficient. Once we rid ourselves of theme, the stars will not be far outside our grasp.
So that could be the words that could be Republicans. So I think it's Republicans, and it was Bob.
He said that the words that would give away who said it are replaced with theme, right?
Yeah. So if it was like Jews, then obviously it would be a Nazi.
I don't know, how does Bob feel about the Jews?
I'm gonna go with Nazi on this one. What do you guys reckon?
Yeah, pretty Nazi. I'm gonna go with Nazi.
Sorry, what were the other votes?
I said Bob, but there were three Nazis there, so...
Oh, okay.
So we got Nazi.
It's possible to see that this is the world and to be angry about it, and to reject false compromise with the other side, without also not recognizing the various complexities and nuances within movements and communities they condemn.
Bob.
Nazi. No, it acknowledges nuance. Nazi.
What?
Bob wouldn't acknowledge nuance.
Bob wouldn't acknowledge nuance.
Well, the thing, like, did you hear? There was not a period in sight in that. That's such a Bob thing to do.
It could be like a modern thing. I think it's someone. I think it's the neo-Nazi going, people don't understand that there's nuance in my belief.
Okay. I'm gonna go with Nazi, I think.
Whereas, I don't think Bob believes in nuance. genuinely, I don't think he believes in nuance.
Wait, what are other votes?
Bob.
Oh. Yeah, I went with Bob.
Two Bobs, one Nazi. Oh, Rags, you're the decider.
Let's do Bob on that one.
Right. No, you fool.
You fool.
People who have no understanding of the political world around them have no right to criticize or complain about our superior future.
That sounds like Bob.
That sounds like Bob.
And I'm pretty sure we remember him saying that at one point.
Bob is always really defeatist about the future.
Yeah, that's the one thing that stops me on that one, is that wouldn't he be like, well, I guess he could be saying it even if they were ruining that superior future?
I could have sworn I seen Bob tweet that too, I'm not sure.
Maybe it's Bob then.
Well, no, don't take my word for it, I wasn't entirely sure about that.
Well, that does strike me as
I'm gonna go with Bob, because I don't think the Nazis would start off kind of soft and understanding like that.
Like, I mean, we've got enough votes for Bob, so we'll just keep going. History likes to forget that theme often grow to assault true progress when the backward and mediocre feel left out of it.
I think I'm starting to see the word that he's using to replace some of the obvious tells.
Well, yeah, he said it was going to be theme.
Yeah.
So that's one of the rules, idiot. God.
Yeah.
Wasn't paying attention, Trump.
History likes to forget that theme often grow to assault true progress when the backward and mediocre feel left out of it. I don't know. What was everyone else
got?
No
idea.
Bob. Or a Nazi.
Nazi. I say Nazi. Let's go with a random one because I don't know.
Okay. What? One more time? I'm sorry.
History likes to forget that theme often grow to assault true progress when the backward and mediocre feel left out of it.
Okay, going with Nazi on that one.
Yeah, okay. Don't tell me to buy inferior products or hire less capable or qualified workers to artificially inflate a semblance of performance. Nobody works for him, right, MovieBob?
I think he works alone.
Imagine him being your boss.
Yeah, I'm going to go with Nazi immediately based on the fact that the potential of hiring workers.
Clean the folds of my balls.
Do you want to work for the big picture?
The American president increasingly used his influence to create conflicts, intensify existing conflicts, and above all, to keep conflicts from being resolved peacefully. For years, this man looked for a conflict anywhere in the world, but preferably in theme that he could use to create political entanglements with American economic obligations to one of the contending sides. which would then steadily involve America in the conflict and thus divert attention from his own confused domestic economic policies.
Yeah, that's way too eloquent. That's Nazi.
I'm going to go with Nazi.
Can I go with Nazi on that one? It also seems longer than a tweet. So
you can put it in multiple tweets.
MovieBob doesn't talk for long.
There needs to be
see him saying that in like the fast voice.
My God, there needs to be a separate category of biology distinguishing theme from properly evolved human beings.
Nazi.
That's Bob.
Bob.
Uh-oh.
I would actually go with Bob first, just because I assume theme could be Republicans there.
Yeah,
Bob.
That's absolutely Republicans. That's 100% Bob. That's Bob.
This is fun.
My dream solution, all the good theme remove themselves from the fray. Let the failed husk collapse in on itself, deprived of all worthy intellects.
That's Bob.
I can't believe I'm I like
to say intellect, so I go with Bob.
I think it's Bob, yeah.
Really intellect. He sounds like intellect. Fucking dictator.
You see, you know, if Bob saw this right, you know what he would think? He'd think, well, yeah, you're removing the word that makes it good or bad. Obviously, yeah. It's better to hate Republicans than Jews. They're not people.
Exactly.
Jews are people.
When I say vast swaths of humanity are beneath contempt, yeah, I speak
for the record,
from knowledge.
It is probably better to hate Republicans than Jews, but like, don't be like that to anyone.
Wow. Yeah, let's don't follow Bob's example.
Like, yeah, don't be either. But
at least Republicans, it's based on values that rather than something they can't control. But like, hating on based on values is better.
Well, you don't have to be a Jew, right?
You can racially. The Nazis hated people who were like ethnically Jewish, not religiously Jewish.
Oh, okay. I mean, the interesting part is just that.
I think they weren't big on the religion either, to be fair.
Statements being extrapolated but then removed of the target, and for some reason it just seems okay. It's like, wipe out this election.
Every time I look at chat, I only see Bob, 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 Bob everywhere.
Like, you know, thinking about it, the Nazis weren't so bad compared to Bob.
At least
the Nazis are ruling, listen.
When I say vast swaths of humanity are beneath contempt, I speak from knowledge, and some of you dare to give me the side eye for calling these themes less than human.
Oh, fuck.
Gonna go with Bob.
That could be Bob again.
I think it's quite
eloquent. Yeah, that's Bob.
I think it's a bit eloquent for
Bob.
That's Bob
complaining out on Twitter.
Yeah, he's probably complaining about Republicans again, you know.
No, actually, yeah, it's probably Bob.
I would put my safety on Bob.
It's not Bob, it's not like the content.
This nation cannot continue letting its future direction be decided by a minority of its least intelligent, most backward-looking people. Most backward-looking people?
Oh my God. No, I think he's back. Like, they look backwards in history or something.
Oh, okay, they're looking backwards.
Not they look ugly or something.
I see. So, probably Bob.
Yeah.
Yeah, that could be Bob. I'm
the entire chat is literally just Bob.
You know, it's like, that's kind of this thing I'm noticing. You notice, like, there's a lot of venom in certain words, and that's more Bob than Nazi.
Yeah, I'm happy to go with Bob. Everyone else?
Yeah, Bob. Yeah. Watch
there
the
is,
twist be them all Bob.
There is, for example, the question of how we came to the preposterous state of affairs prevailing today, wherein we place the destiny of our okay, this isn't Bob. Like, I already don't believe that Bob would write
this. So wait, finish that up?
I mean, it's pretty big, but I already believe from the way that opening was written that it's not Bob.
It does sound pretty Nazi, so.
I did not see that coming.
Right, there's wherein, destiny of our nations. That's Nazi.
I'm going with Nazi. Mm-hmm. Theme is the only way forward for genuine human and technological process. The alternative is the cave.
Bob.
Bob.
I want to say it's Bob as well.
See, this is what happened. This is like, this
it's
is
like, it was sounding Nazi, and then we went to the cave. And it's
what happens when, this is what happens when you let just like your hatred of a group define your worldview. Like you blame all problems on group.
Yeah.
But they both do that.
Yeah,
that's the point. That's the point I'm making. That's why this quiz works so well.
I was gonna say why this fucking game works. Better human beings, upward evolution, theme, that is our way, the only way, to find the answers to the questions that even our greatest philosophers and thinkers have been unable to answer so far.
Nazi.
Probably Nazi.
I'm gonna go with Nazi, yeah.
I'm thinking I'm gonna guess that, yeah.
Trump has opened the door to nationalism in this country. Not American nationalism, but the white race. Once that door is fully swung open, you can't close it.
See, I'm gonna say that, Bob, because Richard Spencer would... like not be critical of that.
Well, it's Wait, was it only Richard Spencer? No, he's not. Isn't critical of it. It's literally just stating that it's like that it's happened.
Well, didn't Richard Spencer say that he regretted voting for Trump?
Yeah, but this could be before that.
Hmm. I'm going with Movie Bob.
He was like, "Wait, everyone was saying he was a white supremacist. What? This isn't anything like what I voted for."
Why are there still black people here?
How come blacks are doing better than ever? This is wrong. Betrayed Trump.
What are you guys voting for?
I'm going to go with Bob. Because this sounds a bit more on the critical end. I would guess that this is a critical post.
Going with Nazi.
I'll go with the Matt.
Yeah, I think this would be. Bob. It's more likely this is critical from Bob than triumphant from Spencer.
But it's
I don't think Nazis believe that Trump is a Nazi.
Oh, of course not, because they'd be like, "Wait, what? No, he's not. We're Nazis."
That's our theme.
Like, no, that does. He's not anything like us.
I don't think I've ever seen Trump do the OK hand sign.
Oh, that's true. Oh my gosh.
It would be funny if he did, though.
I've seen Obama doing it, though. He's a white supremacist.
Oh, my.
Fuck, Obama's a white supremacist.
Yeah, he did the OK sign. It's. I mean, that's not proof. I don't know what is.
Socialism as the final concept of duty, the ethical duty of work, not just for oneself, but also for one's fellow man's sake. And above all, the principle, common good before own good, a struggle against all partisanism. And we are aware that in the fight we can rely on no one but our own people.
I say Nazi.
Nazi.
I'm gonna go with Nazi, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I'm Nazi.
It is thus necessary that the individual should finally come to realize that his opinion is of no importance in comparison with the existence of the nation.
He said his, not there, it's Nazi, not Bob. Bob would say there. Bob thinks that women matter.
Okay.
I mean I'm willing to go with Nazi on this one anyway, because
okay, yeah, so, I agree. Yeah.
Every time a fellow white person asks me if I'd want to be a minority in my country, I tell them I'm already a minority in this country. That's probably Nazi.
Nazi.
Bob, that's Nazi. Nazi.
Bob wouldn't call himself a minority.
Yeah.
No, because he would see himself as like super big-brained and smart, and so he'd consider that a minority.
No, I think he would see it as like devaluing the struggle of self.
Actually, I'm kind of tempted by Rag's argument there. Like, the premise is that some Nazi walks up to Movie Bob, and they're like, "I don't want to be a minority," and then Movie Bob responds, "You're already one. Like, I am too. We're already a minority. Idiot." That sort of thing.
But why would he say we are?
Well...
He wouldn't say we are. He would think that, from Bob's perspective, Bob probably isn't even thinking about race or anything here. He's so focused on his intellect that all that stuff just doesn't even enter into the equation for him when he says something like this. This is all about Bob and his big galaxy brain. And he truly does believe that people like him, dare I say it, the Ubermensch, they are the minority.
Okay, so what's everyone's votes?
I'm thinking this is Bob.
I still think Nazi. I could see Bob saying it, though.
that's the joke of this whole thing. Wait, so what was everyone's Dust Bowl shit and Mel?
Every time a fellow white person
asks me if I want to be the minority in my own country, I tell them I am already a minority in this country.
I'll just say Nazi.
Going Bob.
Nazi Bob, which is just me then.
Nazi Bob.
Nazi Bob.
Who said Nazi Bob?
It can literally go either way, so I... we've had a lot of Bob answers recently, so I'm going to leave it as Nazi. That's how I decided.
Good.
Themes, often film executives or financial moguls, sexually use and abuse women by the thousands, decade after decade, and almost always get away with it. Nobody gets punished. Nobody goes to jail. Every now and then, someone gets exposed publicly for what they are, but it all blows over with the practice continues unabated. That's only half of this quote. Do you reckon it's Bob? Or do you reckon...
I think that's Bob talking about Nazi stuff. Really?
Yeah. That's a Nazi talking about, like, immigrants or something.
No, I think this is Bob talking about the Me Too stuff.
Yeah, same.
I actually think that Jay might be right. It might be a Nazi talking about Jews.
Because that's what I was thinking.
No, I think it's a Nazi talking about Muslim immigrants.
Well, no, because they're referencing film executives, financial moguls,
yeah,
and Harvey Weinstein.
Yeah, Weinstein in the later sentence. So.
Oh, yeah, maybe.
Interrupted me to say what
only,
I was saying.
I think he's only got the Jewish last name as a coincidence. I think this is definitely Bob weighing in on Me Too.
I think it's a trick question, and this just coincidentally has been said by both.
Vote Nazi. What's everyone voting for?
Really? I thought
going with
is,
Bob.
I think this is clearly Bob.
I think Nazi.
It's got to be Bob going on about Me Too.
I'd say Nazi.
Hey, Nazi
really?
Twin.
Wow.
I'm almost certain that themes in that one is Jews. I could be wrong, though. I'm almost certain that themes is Jews.
Alright.
History will eventually remember Theme as a hero, however imperfect, who was failed by the country they tried to save.
Nazi.
Sounds Nazi.
Say that one more time.
History will remember Theme as a hero, however imperfect, who was failed by the country they tried to save.
Is this Bob talking about Hillary?
Is this Bob talking about Hitler?
Bob talking about Hitler.
Actually, it could
be. The thing, I think this is Bob talking about Hillary.
I think it's a Nazi talking about Hitler, but I could, yeah, that could easily be the sneaky thing.
No, but
there.
How did Nazi Germany fail Hitler?
Fucking, I don't know. Ask the person who made this
talking,
quote.
Because Hillary was failed by the country she tried to save because they didn't vote for her.
Didn't, well, you know, Germany, I'm pretty sure, isn't all that big on Hitler anymore, so I think still,
oh, no, we love him.
Oh, shit, I was wrong.
His name is so hallowed, you're not even allowed, for fear of offending his spirit.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly.
I think this is definitely.
This
is
Hitler's dead body, and where is Hitler's body? What happened to it? I'm curious
space.
Now.
It's in my pocket.
What's get it shrunken down.
Just keeping it warm. I don't know.
You just feel like,
help me.
Put it in your bum.
Lass mich raus! No.
Shut up. So, wait. So, what's everyone voting for then?
I say Bob.
I forgot what I did. Nazi, I think it was.
I had voted Nazi, but... man.
I think I voted Nazi.
Some pretty sound arguments for Bob.
Yeah, I think you can make a good argument for Bob. I'm gonna go with Nazi though, and just.
I think it's much more likely that Bob would be upset at the country for not voting for her than a Nazi would say that Germany failed Hitler by losing the war when they fought so incredibly hard.
Yeah, and for that reason, I'm gonna have to go with Bob.
Oh, so that's. Is that 2-3?
Well, it sounds like 2-3.
I've never heard it said that the Germans didn't fight hard enough to defend Germany.
I don't know, man. I think to become full-on Nazi, you probably have to have a few screws loose in the first place.
I don't think so.
No.
No, I don't think so. I don't think I'd be crazy to be a Nazi.
Hey, what? Screws loose can mean a lot of things, but
No, I mean that. You think every Nazi's a crazy person? Or do you think they have reasons for why they justify what
they do? Their reasons are so crazy that they
have to be so, like, unless they've been, like, just told that that's the way things are and they've never been exposed to anything else, I think you have to be pretty crazy to be a Nazi.
I don't think it's about insanity. No.
If they were insane, how defining crazy?
I wouldn't say that about socialists or communists or Nazis. Like, I don't think that about religious people.
Yeah.
I don't think that about Scientologists.
Yeah, okay,
or
to be a Nazi in the modern day, not a Nazi.
Do you really feel that way about Scientology? Yeah, I do.
Yeah, kind of.
It's not the world. Nah, yeah, Scientology is the world's fakest religion. Don't worry, Shad. Nowadays I'd say, I guess, more so, but I'm hesitant, especially nowadays, to chalk people's beliefs up to, oh, you're crazy.
Yeah.
I think it leads us down a bad, I don't think it's good when we just dismiss people as being crazy, because people feel and believe the things they do for a reason.
Yeah.
Anything,
and that just
when they're Nazis, though, I don't feel like it does too much harm.
I'm not sure referring to a medical illness. I'm just saying the way that they critically analyze the situation is probably flawed.
Yes.
Yeah, it's certainly flawed. Yeah, I think they're wrong. Absolutely.
Yeah.
But I'm not going to say that it's they're necessarily acting in a way that they don't believe it's irrational. That's the thing.
But no one ever believes they're irrational.
Well, sure.
Like, that's...
But I don't think that... Yeah, but it's not because they're crazy or anything. They don't think the ceiling tiles are trying to eat them.
I think we're probably just going on different definitions. You have to have a very distorted understanding of reality.
Probably, but I think that's...
So
I think
that's that would, if we go by that definition, like, if I say that's what I mean when I say crazy, would you agree?
No, because I think before we found out that we lived in a heliocentric universe, it would make everyone crazy.
So, well, I'm not saying that Nazis would have been crazy in Germany.
I don't think that's a fair comparison, right? Because with the information everybody had at the time, that's not a fair comparison to what... Like a Scientologist will have to deal with.
I don't think that if you're a Nazi today, you're crazy. Like an insane person.
I think you are crazy if you're a Nazi today.
I don't think so. I think that you could reason
heavily indoctrinated.
Yeah, potentially. You can certainly be indoctrinated, yeah.
So if you're heavily indoctrinated...
Then would that even make you crazy?
And
I don't think being indoctrinated makes you crazy.
You're either a sheep or you're crazy.
Yeah.
One of the two.
I mean, I think, are flat earthers crazy?
Yes.
Because I'm not ready to say that they're crazy.
Yes, I think they're crazy. I think they're insane.
No, I think that a lot of them
actually... just drop the word crazy because it clearly could mean a lot of things at the same time.
Yeah, I think they're certainly, just like Nazis, are fucking wrong.
Like, someone who says, Joker really had no reason to be punched by Thomas Wayne is crazy, and simultaneously says the Nazi ideology is crazy, would be like... Two very different levels of crazy. It depends on what you mean by crazy.
Yeah, I'll say Hitler was... Yeah, he got pretty loopy.
Hitler was
pretty loopy.
Yeah, he was pretty loopy.
Man, he had a fucking screw loose, eh?
He's a goofy dude.
He was goofy.
That's, yeah. You know, you can have 100 screws and have one loose. It's okay.
I mean, you can have terrible beliefs and horrible beliefs and be totally wrong about things, but that doesn't mean that you're not applying some level of rationality, even if it's not complete and total. You could be operating from a different value system. You could be informed by a different history. You could identify with certain things differently in other ways. But I wouldn't say this about anybody just because you have a political position.
I don't know, maybe I'm only speaking for myself here, but maybe Jay would go a little bit further.
Oh yeah, I know it's a political position, but I don't think, I'm not going to say people are crazy because of a political position that they hold. I think it goes deeper than that.
It counts as a political position. It's like,
I know. Yeah. I just said that does.
Wait, I thought you said it. You said it does or it doesn't.
It does. Yes, Nazi is definitely a political position.
Maybe it was. I don't see it as that.
I'm gonna say I'm not going to call people crazy because they have a political position.
I'm
finding out why they think that, and hopefully, if it's bad,
but I wouldn't put as much on. Like, so if they were like, "You think I'm mentally handicapped?" I'd be like, okay, look, no, I was just saying that I think that that's crazy. I use the word very softly.
In like a colloquial, casual way. Sure, if that's how we're using it. Like, it's crazy. It's crazy people think the earth is flat, but I don't think that these people are necessarily crazy. I'm sure some of them might be.
Like, yeah. What you're saying is you don't necessarily think they have mental...
Like, if I actually was convinced that they were mentally impaired...
That would be one of the last things I would assume, is that they have mental issues.
Well, no, I would assume... It's not the last thing I would assume, but like... You know,
I suppose I could think of they were abducted by aliens and their mind was like, sure, but
if someone was a Nazi, I would be more inclined to believe they had a mental issue. I wouldn't assume it immediately. No, like, based on clinical mental issues, no, I would.
I don't know. It's not even something
that's
I would
a requirement.
Think of. When I would be diagnosing a communist or a Nazi or a Scientologist or a flat earther or something like that, I wouldn't even be like, well, are they insane in the brain? It just wouldn't even occur to me, I guess.
Yeah, do we need to give them, how many pills do we need to give him to make him cool again?
Like, I would arrive at that maybe eventually after I go through everything based on how they responded to questions and things of that nature. Like, if a flat earther said something, like if they brought in to question... So in just really far out conspiracies and space aliens and interdimensional stuff, then yeah, I might be like, yeah, you might be a little, you might be not all there, but I certainly wouldn't be nearly the first thing I'd consider.
Well, I think we're in agreement based on, like, if we remove the word crazy from the equation and just go by definition, someone who is a Nazi does not necessarily have a clinical disorder, like, you know, a diagnosable problem with their brain, right? We're in agreement about that. But
yeah, like, there's nothing wrong with their brain speaking, in sort of like a mental way.
You know, they are colloquially speaking crazy in the
yeah,
sense
like,
that
yeah,
they
like
are.
That fight scene in the movie was crazy, and wow, this cheesecake was crazy delicious, and yeah, so like,
well,
that,
not
yeah.
You know, that's not the same meaning, but you know, like, they're both adjectives, never mind, but you know.
Yeah,
you ever see the crazies, Jay?
They're not right.
I agree. They're not right.
Correct.
But it's all like
they're not. There's something not right about them. Like,
I was like, sure.
In the same way, I would say that someone who, if we want to say if there's something not right about them in the sense that I think they're incorrect on political positions, then sure.
Mm-hmm.
And I would extend that to technically everyone who holds a position that I don't have by technicality, sure, because I think that all my positions are correct, which is why I have them, but
Nazis to a more extreme degree than, like, you know,
if I was convinced they'd come to their conclusions because of a mental impairment, I probably wouldn't be like, wow, they're crazy. I'd be like, oh shit, they might, like, actually have, you know, like, a problem. Like, that's probably how I would actually approach that.
Yeah, right. I'm definitely in the camp that you destroy your enemy if you turn them into a friend, and I think that the last thing we need to do is make people outcasts.
Well, yeah, but there's a line, like, we're not the people to be befriending Nazis. There's
I'm not.
Of separation.
Kind of, no, just so we just abandon.
Well, like, be nice to them, but like be nice smart. To them and you know, treat them like human beings to try and help fix them. But,
well, I see a Nazi as a victim.
Tolerate their beliefs
in a way. Like, I think that they've been, for some reason, convinced of a terrible position, and I think that their lives and our lives would be better the less of them existed. So I think, in a way, it's kind of, in a sense, it is kind of our duty to help them, don't you?
Oh, yeah, I agree with that. To help them out of that view.
But, and I think, like, it's just pragmatic that you don't want to be overly combative with anybody to change.
Yeah, because that doesn't change hearts and minds, just, you know, screaming in their face.
But so anything, I feel like what I'm doing isn't helping those who have already fallen. I think it's helping other people not to fall, essentially.
Well, you can do that before they kill. If they have the Nazi ideology and before they go through with anything, you can convince them, you know, carefully rather than screaming
in
their face.
I'm much less inclined to believe that random people will become Nazis, especially nowadays, than I am thinking that I could certainly change a Nazi's opinion. Especially when I get emails from people that tell me that I've de-radicalized them in a certain way or helped change their way of thinking mm-hmm. and things of that nature.
Yeah, it can happen. You just don't want to freaking dehumanize them constantly, and then that just doesn't help.
Saying someone's being like someone is crazy is dehumanizing them,
right? But just, you know, saying, oh, they just have irrational thoughts constantly and they just need a couple pills and they'll stop believing the way they do. It's like, that's
I'm not saying
not
have pills. I'm saying they should have, like, pills. I'm saying, yeah, they have irrational.
Yeah, I don't think that. Yeah, I think that you can. I think
they're
that.
Okay, let's go with this. They're irrational.
I believe they're behaving irrationally.
Yay, we got there.
I say behaving. They're thinking irrationally. I don't know if their behavior is technically.
Well, if they're expressing that they're a Nazi, then they're behaving irrationally.
Anyway, MovieBob's not a very good person. Shall we continue?
Well, it all started because I was. It was like, wouldn't it be irrational to assume that Germany didn't do everything they could to support Hitler in the fight?
Right.
And
someone says it, same rags that makes videos that just said it's not conducive to be overly combative. Well, I'm not. I'm really doing it more for an audience than a single person. Because a single person makes the video, but hundreds of thousands of people see the video. So that's an aspect of it, but I think that it's time for us to continue with the quiz.
And with that, we're sticking with that.
Also, it's not like I still think that someone could conclude that Germany didn't do, like, some irrational person could consider the Germany to have failed Hitler in that they weren't 100% on board, because there was plenty of people in Germany who worked against him.
Lots of people who weren't Nazis.
No, I mean actual Nazis who worked against him.
Well, like, would they be Nazis if they worked against him and his goals? Maybe they were like, they're Nazis, but
I suppose
they,
I was calling them Nazis as a classification of just their label at that point, not like what they actually believe specifically. But the point I'm trying to make is that you've got someone could believe that those very people are the reason that he fell, or the World War II didn't work out for him. There's gonna be somebody out there.
I think it was actually Arch actually was talking about a book. Someone, I was in a stream with Arch and Sargon and Dev and Uzalu the other day, and someone had asked in a super chat if they recommended any like World War II books, and Arch had mentioned one about like older. I might be remembering this inexactly, but he said something along the lines of older people, as things got more and more dire for Germany, more and more people who weren't proper young soldier men were recruited to help, you know, defend Germany. And a lot of them were just old dudes who were too old to really buy into all the Nazi stuff. They were just Germans and they wanted to defend Germany. And it's a story about them and how they, you know, mixed and melted with a more younger type of person who might be more ideological about it. But it's certainly complicated.
As you referenced that, so did all caps said, read a book for fuck's sake. It's like timing was perfect.
Someone said it was Dev. Hey, Dev, thank you very much. I couldn't quite remember.
Yeah, basically, I'm certain that either could say it. The likelihood...
Ordinary Men, I've just been told on Discord. Thank you for that sign up.
The likelihood of it being Movie Bob over a Nazi, I think I would agree at this point, is more likely to be Bob.
Yeah, I'm sticking with Bob.
Say, if it's not long, could you say it again? Because I've forgotten what it is.
History will eventually remember Theme as a hero, however imperfect, who was failed by the country they tried to save.
Yeah, I think that's Bob talking about Hillary after the 2016 election, because they didn't vote for her.
Yeah.
I think Bob has ever had sex.
I suppose, yeah. Would a Nazi refer to...
No.
Why'd you make me think about that?
Why'd you come to my basement apartment and put these blue overalls on?
I'm genuinely, like, curiously trying to think about it. Like, would he have...
No, why?
I think that Bob would almost look down at it as a base biological distraction.
No. By the way, thanks for the reminder of the book. I have that book.
Like, he certainly masturbates to, like, himself, but I don't think
in the green screen.
I think when he climaxes, he screams, "Take my seed," even if he's just
No,
stop!
He comes green all over his wall.
No.
That was never paint.
Oof said this segment was a bad idea. What's the point? Look, Movie Bob's rhetoric is similar to that of racists. It's like, yes, that was the point.
Yeah,
that was the point.
Yeah.
it's been...
I'm gonna go with Bob.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's a fair choice. Jay, you stick with the Nazis?
Yeah, I'll stick with the Nazis.
Okay.
And Metal?
I don't even remember.
Okay, well, assuming that... Wait, if that was true, then the Nazis would have it anyway.
Already, so it doesn't
matter. Have three Bobs, yeah.
Sorry, the Bobs would have it, yeah.
Gut feeling, right?
It was interesting. Some people have just been referencing different events, including Operation Valkyrie, which, yeah, it was super interesting to learn about what all that was and how it all went down.
Also, I have the book Ordinary Men. I have it in my hand right now. I totally forgot I have it.
You have what?
You mentioned it. The book Rex just mentioned, Ordinary Men.
Yes.
I have that in my hand right now.
Oh, my goodness.
I never read it. I bought it, like, years ago. But I always forgot about it. So I just put it on my desk now, so I actually read a book again in years.
I will never forgive Theme for this. A superior global future was in sight and they threw it away.
Bob.
That sounds like
that's
Bob.
That's Bob.
I'd go with
that's,
Bob.
That's the 2016 elections
Nazis
again.
Nazis wouldn't refer to themselves as they.
Oh, that was something else I was going to say, by the way, was that... Theme, however imperfect, was failed by the country tried to save. I was just thinking, would a Nazi refer to Hitler as imperfect?
Exactly.
Oh yeah, that as well.
And you know, referring to Hillary as imperfect, I think is the fucking the lowest you can go. Before you, yeah. Oh wait, I didn't switch the answer. That's my bad.
It'd be funny if we get a really low score.
Yeah,
like, Bob, and I know, like, Chad, I think this is an easy Bob.
Well, the funny thing about the funny thing about whatever happens, if we score low, that means that we, well, it could mean a lot of things. Actually,
I guess the worse we do, the
more tragic this whole thing becomes.
I think it's tragic no matter what, because we would have attributed Bob to Nazis and Nazis to Bob. And if we were right on everything, that's not good either. It's just all bad for Bob.
Like, it's it looks bad, but the wronger we are, the funnier it is.
I suppose, yes.
Can't tell.
Yeah.
And that is really the only possible response to that question, because this film doesn't even bother to attempt to provide any form of plausible deniability. That is shameless celebration of violence by white men against a society that has abandoned them. Joker is a love letter to mass shooters.
Bob.
That means it's Bob.
I would guess Bob, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
having trouble thinking about how it could be anything else.
Yeah, I don't know what neo-Nazis.
The fact that makes me think it's a bait and switch, and it's.
True.
I don't know what the problem. I'm trying to think. Going through Joker, if I'm looking at from an alt-right perspective, what would they have against it?
Black women.
He kissed a black woman.
Joker hates black women.
If I like,
because they don't laugh at his jokes.
Let's see.
Miscegenation. I know that word now because of the bullshit.
Yeah, I think that's a Bob one.
That's Bob.
The nation I love and thought was heading in the right direction is failing, and I can only blame the ignorance of my fellow countrymen.
I don't think Bob would say countrymen.
I was going to say countrymen doesn't sound like a Bob word.
Yeah, that's a Nazi.
I don't think Bob identifies with, like, I don't think Bob would ever say my fellow countrymen. I think say idiots.
He's like these idiots who occupy the same nation as me.
They breathe the same air.
I'm sorry. We're saying it's probably a Nazi because he talks about people as if they're human.
Yeah, I feel like a Nazi would be nicer.
No. Yeah.
Than Bob. Yeah.
Certainly more camaraderie amongst Nazis than Bob. I would say
there is a lot of among
everyone is below Bob. And well, because
with
about
Nazis,
it every time,
there's
Bob.
Like this a definite in-group, but with Bob, it's he goes it alone in such a clear way so often.
He
hoists himself up
left.
On his pedestal.
He thinks the left is in-group, but they hate him. Like,
it's tragic.
The group he thinks
really,
is his hates him.
The fact that no one wants to hear is wait. The fact that no one wants to hear is this. Not everyone. I'm sorry. Maybe I'm getting really old. I'm gonna copy and send you it while I.
The fact that no one wants to hear is this. Not everyone gets to win. Even if you yourself aren't a theme is a superior way forward into a better future for a better world.
Bob,
I'm going Nazi.
Going Nazi.
What could theme be?
That's a good point.
Area?
Even if not everyone gets to win, not everyone gets to win, even if you yourself aren't a Nazi. German.
Then eugenics is a superior.
Aryan.
Oh, yeah. Then eugenics is a superior way forward for a better future and a better world.
Yeah, because those two themes could be different words.
Yeah, they could be.
I think. Okay,
Bob possibly conceding that he can't win at something is just...
No, he's not conceding that he can't win. He's saying that other people don't get to win. The person who's saying this is saying that other people don't get to win because they are the best, I think.
Not everyone gets to win, even if you yourself aren't a loser?
They're saying even if you yourself aren't the in-group, our group's ideology is the best way forward, so you're just going to get put to the sidelines if you're something else. That's the quote.
I think this could be also Bob speaking towards people who don't see themselves as losers, but saying that even if you don't see yourself like that, that doesn't mean you win. That doesn't mean you've won. That doesn't mean you're in a good position.
I'm going to go with
even
Nazi.
If you don't think of yourself as a loser, but this one's tough.
Go with Nazi. I think it's, I think the word is like, even if you saw you yourself.
I might, yeah, this one's tough.
Going Nazi on this.
I'll go Nazi.
To be fair, I don't think a Nazi would appeal to someone who isn't an Aryan. Like
the Nazis have it. I'm gonna just make sure we're moving forward.
Jay,
we're like a third of the way through this.
No, this could be Nazis appealing to Germans who aren't part of the Nazi Party, saying that you might not feel like a loser, but you don't. All right,
let's just go with Nazi then.
So I think this could be. I think this could go both ways. I think this is probably the closest so far, but I'm gonna go with Nazi.
Yeah, I've always felt in some way apart from theme, but never so much as right now. How can I share DNA with these monsters? Oh my god. I want to go with Bob, yeah.
Bob.
This was like after the election.
Every of the worst ones we assume is after the election.
It's like, he's just so talking about just like Homo sapiens. Like, I'm the same species as these Republicans, these moderates. These
it's okay, bro. We have to be the same species as you, as we don't like.
It's a shame that we leave the abilities of the nation at the mercy of citizens who act with these abilities lightly and as if they were playing a game.
I'm going with Nazi.
Too eloquent.
Yeah, I'll happily go with Nazi. Freedom of expression is nice, but it becomes a factor of corruption, and corruption, if not excised within the limits set by the interest of the nation.
Nazi. Bob doesn't care about the interests of the nation. Well. He cares about. Am I cutting out of there?
A little bit.
No, Bob doesn't care about the interests of the nation. He would never talk about the nation. That's Nazi speak.
Yeah, I think Bob views the nation as almost like, I have to be. It's like,
yeah.
The way the world is, I just unfortunately have to be in this nation with these people around me.
Yeah.
Nazi then.
Nazi it is. Theme are not motivated by the desire to defend a scientific idea or to spread this idea, but by the bigotry of opinion, idea, or belief.
Bob.
Ooh. Nope, this is really eloquent though.
Yeah, I'm thinking Nazi on this one.
But would Nazi say bigotry?
Maybe a modern Nazi.
Bob. Yeah. That's what, because that's what I'm thinking. We have to keep remembering there are still, like, you know,
Richard Spencer. I probably a Nazi then.
So wait. So what's everyone's votes?
Nazi.
Nazi. But wait. What was yours, Mel?
Bob.
Okay. Nazi Bob. Can't Bob.
Be right, I was drinking something.
And what was yours, Jay?
Nazi.
Oh fuck. Okay. What would be about deciding to defend a scientific idea? I'm gonna go with Nazi. I don't know. I don't know if Bob would put it this way. I feel like it should be more clunky if it's Bob.
Yeah.
Theme were given a choice to evolve and become a superior theme, or stagnate and remain inferior. The majority chose wrong. Oh my
Bob.
God.
Bob.
Going with Bob.
I can't believe this is what I mean. Like, this is the part of it that's shocking. It's just like, I guess that was Bob, but I can't believe that Bob said that. It's like, whoa. But it all makes sense.
What a rotten soul.
I hope Bob finds out that this has happened.
Mm-hmm. In those days, I was stupid enough to try and enlighten Theme about the meaninglessness of their beliefs, though I could show them the danger of Theme, but I was getting the opposite result.
Hmm.
Nazi.
I don't know. I'll post it for you guys.
In those days, I was stupid enough to try. No, Bob would never acknowledge that he had a.
Nazi. I said Nazi.
I think I'm going to go with Nazi as well. What was
I think Nazi. But it's close. It's just. I think it's the grammar that's giving it away. It is.
We've gone off grammar and punctuation a lot. And the fucking venomous words that he uses.
I'm here.
Gut reaction, Rags. In those days, I was stupid enough to try and enlighten Theme about the meaninglessness of their beliefs, though I thought I could show them the danger of Theme, but I was getting the opposite result.
In fact, I could absolutely see... What? Because Nazis aren't based on other people's beliefs. I mean, no, actually, it could be a neo-Nazi talking about, like, liberal.
Well, and does Bob really strike you as somebody who will talk to someone and try to convince anyone?
No, he's talking
anyone?
In the past. This is past tense.
Yeah,
I
maybe
used to.
Used to. I'm not sure I buy that, though.
I think that I could be reasoned with, essentially.
I could absolutely see Bob, because it's essentially going, these people can't be reasoned with. They need genocide the Republicans. Like,
yeah, that seems very much, but this is the guy who would absolutely Thanos snap half the country away.
No, he said that, didn't he?
I'm going to go with Bob on this one.
But I could see it being a Nazi as well. I could totally be a Nazi.
Oh, no, I don't know.
Fuck!
Just based on the grammar, it's the Nazi, though.
I don't know. I think Bob has his moments of, grammatically.
Statistically, most of the stuff he says is an incoherent mess. So,
is this the same guy that did that EFAP quiz of?
I can't remember if that was the same guy. I don't think that was the same guy, as far as I remember. But it could be.
It's Adam Hilt.
I thought I could show them the danger of theme could be the danger of Trump. As in MovieBob saying that, right? Possible?
Bob was too far gone by the time Trump was.
Yeah.
But surely he would still sell himself as being like a savior? Or like tried to help them?
We're saying this is like a lie?
Possibly. It's MovieBob. How do you imagine he tried to argue?
Thinking that this is a lie makes it seem a lot more plausible than Bob said it.
Yeah.
I used to be stupid enough to think these people could be turned, but.
Okay, fine.
That's why I don't convince nobody no more. It's because they're all stupid. Yeah, and I tried. Because
Bob likes to try and justify the things that he does by often being in a very malicious and unfeeling way.
Bob sees himself as a Mary Sue. My flaw was that I was too good.
He tried. Damn it, he tried.
Yeah, I'm gonna go with Bob on this.
Yeah, I'm happy to go with Bob.
All right, I've changed my mind. It's Bob.
Although the wording does make me think Nazi, but sure, Bob.
Maybe.
I'm not for the correct action to be overridden in favor of the will of the stupid just because they happen to occupy more space. Bob. That's Bob.
That's Bob.
As for democracy, I believe in results and long-term vision. Systems, not so much. In this regard, I'm closer to a technocrat.
Technocrat.
Bob.
I haven't seen him use that word, but I could believe he said this.
I have to Google what it means. Hang on.
Yeah, I think that I think that super forward thinking future Bob would definitely talk about technocrat.
I think that's Bob.
All right.
I think technocrat is one of the three words that Bob knows.
Hey, let's leave massively important geopolitical decisions with potential global impact up to a public vote, said no one smart. This is a really bad idea. Bob. Your fellow theme failed you. I know the feeling. Yeah, okay.
Bob often talks really fits in about how terrible the voter base is and how stupid they are. He laments he has to abide by their decisions.
Theme cannot be won over, saved, or reasoned with. They need to be defeated along with their values and political power.
Nazi. Uh-huh.
Yeah, Nazi.
You don't think that could be Bob?
It could be, but I think
Bob would say eliminated.
Yeah, but I think this is a Nazi one.
Eliminated. Because
this could easily, like, we've been thinking about all of these. We've been thinking all like the nuances of speech in terms of what they might say nowadays, but that could probably be an old quote, and we've just been, our mindset has been changed as of lately.
I'm still gonna go with Nazi on this one.
Yeah, Nazi.
Yeah, I think the Nazis have it. Most people don't know what is best for them, and in taking actions under Bob. The assumption that they do, often mess things up for us. Yeah, I think that's Bob.
Oh, yeah.
It's too eloquently worded, though. That's the only thing.
Yeah, but it's not, it's eloquent, but it's not fancy.
What if it turns out all the ones you've been saying are, like, too eloquent, turn out to be written by him? How are you gonna feel?
I mean, it's eloquent in a sense that it's a simple sentence.
Well, then, okay, yeah, sure.
Yeah. Well, what I'm waiting for is for this test to turn up all Bob. And we were all duped.
They're all Bob.
The trick is that it was all
Bob. Oh my god,
we
can do that.
Sometimes I am dumbfounded. I don't know what amazed me more, the abundance of their verbiage or the artful way in which they dressed up their falsehoods. I hate them.
Nazi.
Nazi.
I'm going with Nazi.
Yeah, I'm going to go with Nazi on this.
Okay, Nazi, yep.
Because Bob would never refer to his enemies as eloquent or, all that.
Yeah, no, everybody's stupider than Bob.
Yeah, Bob would never pay them that kind of a backhanded compliment.
Wait. The superior future of the United States is technological in theme. Until then, a lot of noise. Bob, I guess?
I don't think Bob is hopeful.
I'm going to say Bob, because that whole technocrat thing.
Yeah, it fits his technocrat profile. It doesn't fit his... I don't think he thinks that it's actually going to happen. I think he thinks that, like, everyone is stupid and sabotaging it for him.
Yeah, he fancies himself, like, he envisions actually himself in the problem. Same way that a lot of modern-day revolutionaries envision things, where they're going to be at the top, they're going to be card-carrying party members, they're not going to be the ones working in fields. You know, they fancy themselves in these privileged positions, and I think Bob especially really does think that.
I think this one's Bob.
Yeah, I think he's going to be one of the technocratic elites.
Yep, so Bob.
So long as there are employees who attack social understanding and have wrong ideas of justice and fair play, it is not only the right but also the duty of their employee to protect their general interests against the greed and unreasonableness of the individual.
I'm going to go with Nazi.
Nazi.
Now go Nazi. Yes, I condemn democracy as it currently exists in the country, which is quite anachronistically... Well. Still called by the name United States of America. I think that's Bob.
Yeah, Bab! Using those big stupid-ass words.
Here's a nice picture to mark the halfway point. The following picture includes major spoilers for Hell. View at your own risk. Yes.
What? I want to see it.
Spoil Hell for me, Dad.
Oh my, that is not a flattering photo. I don't know if it's actually him or not. I just, oof.
I just, oof. Okay.
Within my lifetime, one of these theme are going to make their own country, institute basically socialism to streamline the economy and act like they invented something totally new.
Oh yeah, that's him.
Wait, do you think the quote is or the picture is?
The picture is.
What do we think, everyone?
Thinking Bob.
I don't know.
They're going to make their own country.
This is what a feminist looks like? Poor feminists.
I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know. I think I might have to just defer to the group decision on this one.
I say Nazi.
Yeah.
Is Bob openly for socialism?
Probably. It wouldn't surprise me.
I don't know. I don't think that the idea of that would appeal to him much. I think he'd be like, I think he's more of a, he wouldn't phrase it this way, but he's more of a technocrat.
This doesn't quite feel like something he'd say to me, but you know, I'm not a Bob historian, so.
Yeah, I mean, as much as Bob takes too much of a shit on the blue collar people of the world to give, you know, he doesn't give me socialist vibes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, to be a socialist, you have to believe in the good of the people, I think, and Bob doesn't.
Yeah, yeah. Bob is definitely not a...
Definitely not.
Not that.
So, we good with Nazi?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Theme and theme Nazi. Represent two distinctly divergent, irreconcilable...
You can't read
irreconcilable.
Oh, yeah. Irreconcilable. Paths of societal development. And they are in conflict. One will defeat the other, and there will be either a future for their theme, a future for theme, or there will not.
Nazi.
Very dramatic.
Nazi.
I did not see that coming.
I could see Bob saying it, but I think I'm edging toward the Nazi.
One more time, please.
Theme and theme represent two distinctly different, divergent, irreconcilable paths of societal development, and they are in conflict. One will defeat the other, and there will either be a future for theme, or there will not.
Going with Bob.
Which was it? What's everyone's take?
Nazi.
I'll go with Nazi.
I think I'm going with Nazi as well.
Okay.
I could see Bob doing it, but you know. Hell yes, America should confiscate the wealth of millionaire traitors. We're not going to allow it to be used to erode the rights of our fellow Americans anymore.
Ooh, that's hard. I think it's Bob, but it's like it's a close one because it's so well worded.
Wait a minute. He said fellow Americans.
Oh, I don't know. Yeah. I don't know. I think I'd go with Nazi on that one.
Nazi.
Me too.
Yeah, Nazi.
I'm gonna go with the Nazi.
People like this are the base level source of the soul sickness that holds our whole society back from becoming the better world that the intelligent and worthwhile theme deserve. Bob. It'll be great when this is over and I can go back to despising backwards human filth threatening our future without hearing their bullshit regurgitated by themes or the media telling me I should feel sorry for them. Bob.
That's so hard though.
Dude. That's Bob as fuck, dude.
Human
Come on.
Filth. We assume it's Bob immediately.
Yeah, dude. He hates it. He hates everyone but himself.
Yeah, but like Nazis hate Jews. That's like the thing.
I understand that, but like human filth.
But it's Bob, Jay.
It's such a Bob thing to say.
I don't think Bob would call them human.
The logic here is astounding. Like,
oh my god, I thought we were to be in called, agreement on this one.
To be called human filth is a level above what Bob would say.
Still going with Bob.
Yeah, the Bobs have it with that one. Each of us must decide just how far we will let the situation in America deteriorate into backwardness and theme before we decide to take action to correct it. I urge you to become involved for your children's sake, if not your own.
Nazi.
I'm gonna go with the Nazi, I think.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go with Nazi.
Alright.
Sure.
Some of the most...
Bob doesn't seem interested in the next generation.
Some of the most dishonest people...
Oh, that's a
people...
great show.
Somebody cares a lot about that in the next generation.
Yeah.
Some of the most dishonest people can be identified by the use of the phrase, war never solved anything. Of course it does. If they were honest, they would say theme never solves problems.
Nazi.
Almost Nazi.
I think Nazi, yeah. Marriage
Nazi
must...
Bob believes in war.
How do you? Can you imagine Bob serving?
You imagine Bob serving in like a war?
Soldier Bob. Marriage must indeed be refounded on a much more radical level than that imagined by the egalitarian religious right and constitutionalists.
I think that's Bob.
I think that's Bob.
That's so
like, I hated Bob. Reading that.
Dude, that was such a salad. What the fuck was that?
Yeah, actually,
that
was Bob.
Bob tweets. So go Bob.
Yeah, gonna go with Bob.
The only reason to fear theme is if you are a weak and or worthless person who can only hope to hold social power by theme. A truly superior individual would not resist an evolving world.
I'm trying to desperately figure out what theme
couldn't
might
be. Couldn't that be Bob? Because...
I guess it could going be. With Nazi.
Yeah, That's a tough one. I don't know. I think I'll just kind of go with whatever anyone else decides. That I can see that one going both ways really easily.
Yeah, I kind of want to stay on the fence as well, so it'll be between the remaining three.
Nazi.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, sorry Jay, it's a Nazi. The US is only going to stagnate until people get on board with the idea that theme, as a mindset, place, and demographic, needs to be aggressively beaten, constrained, and neglected to the point of erasure by any means available. We must do this if our people are going to progress at all. Oh my god.
That sounds pretty Bobby.
I mean, I think that might actually just cross over the line that Bob wouldn't say that, but like he wouldn't. Optics-wise.
Say it one more time.
The US is only going to stagnate until people get on board with the idea that theme, as a mindset, place, and demographic, needs to be aggressively beaten, constrained, and negated to the point of erasure by any means available. We must do this if our people are going to progress at all.
That's...
Our people.
I feel like the our
yeah,
people.
Yeah, Bob wouldn't say our people. Bob wouldn't say our people.
Nazi it is.
Damn it. It's Nazi.
Yeah, I feel like it's more on the collective-y side.
It'd be funny if we're wrong on that. I don't think that anyone is less than human. Just less
not
than
Nazi.
Me.
Bob.
Don't...
Oh, actually, no. Actually, that could be Bob.
Not less than me.
Is that a Hitler
it's definitely
quote?
Bob.
It's, that's only half of the quote. You guys are outraged.
Bob,
the other half is don't get upset. Well, it says don't give upset, but I think it's supposed to be don't get upset about it. Tons of people are beneath me.
Bob.
Did he really like tweet that? No. Holy shit.
When he said, I don't think any people are below human, I'm like, obviously Bob believes some people are below human, so I think that's fair.
Yeah.
No, this is him trying to like save face in a way. He's like, no, they're human. They're just definitely Bob. Beneath me.
They're not human. They're human. They're just shit humans.
Yeah.
I can believe it's Bob, but holy fuck. Maybe he would say that one's a joke. He's apparently said some of his tweets are definitely jokes. I'm always like, which one?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. He's like, oh, that's news to me.
At a certain point.
The tweet is a joke when he says.
At a certain point, you have to become comfortable with the idea that huge swaths of people are so theme and theme that they barely qualify as human. Bob?
Bob.
Bob.
It's Bob.
Anytime someone's not allowed to be human.
I want to say Nazi.
Yeah, like Nazis, I think, treat some people as inhuman. Like, you know, I think that's something they might.
No.
I think they would straight up say some people are subhuman. Bob is just like, oh, no, they're barely, don't worry, I said barely human, guys.
They qualify in that they can English.
Something
Bob will
would
speak
say
a language.
Barely human. Nazis would say subhuman.
Yeah, because Bob's trying, shockingly, Bob knows that he can't get banned from Twitter. Oh, that would really hurt. So he's trying to not get banned from Twitter.
You're trying to like a squeeze in a technicality or something?
Something like that.
All theme are unsalvageable. Failed humans. Reject them and push them out.
Bob.
Nazi.
Theme could be Jews.
No, but like I don't think Nazis see Jews as failures. I think I don't think Nazis think that Jews had an opportunity to fail. They just think they're like, they're shit anyway.
Yeah, I'm still going with Nazis.
Sees, like, you don't have to like fail to be a Jew from a Nazi's perspective. You just are a Jew.
I would say Bob on this one.
Yeah, I'm going with Bob.
I think I would settle on Bob if I had to choose, but I'm also okay with being on the fence on this one.
Yeah, I'm pretty okay with being on the fence on most of them. That's the point of the quiz.
Wait, so if we've got Nazi, Bob, and fence, I guess I would have to pick Bob because I said I'm slightly more toward Bob than I am toward Nazis.
Go for it.
Very well. Normal people are trash. No one that ever mattered was normal. Exceptional elite people build and drive the world and get called theme for their trouble. Bob?
Bob.
Pretty Bob.
Imagine
I don't think Bob would use the word elite. I think Bob sees the elite as a bad thing.
Well, the elite are bad as long as the elite isn't me.
Yeah, but Bob thinks that I don't think Bob thinks that he is the elite. I think Bob thinks he's like amazing and perfect.
I don't know, man.
The word elite. I think he uses the word elite to describe like the people in power who are evil.
Well, it depends on what kind of word they're using that for, because elite is often referred to the people who are like the most powerful on Earth, but he could be referring to just the best people.
That's why I think it's not Bob.
What does everyone else think?
Bob.
I'm gonna go with Bob.
I'm gonna go with Bob.
You fools.
I was gonna go with Bob as well. I'm sorry, Jay.
Imagine... whole chat is still just Bob.
Just Bob.
They have the answers to the quiz already.
They could have got that by now, so yeah. You never know who's actually got the answers or not. Imagine how annoying the people harassing me would be if I could bring myself to think of them as humans.
Bob.
I'm thinking Bob.
Yeah.
Bob.
Twitter harassment.
Could be a Nazi, though. That's the thing.
If theme prevails as the driving force of the 21st century, you can kiss everything from space travel to disease cures goodbye. That's Bob. Mm-hmm. Space travel is, yeah.
It's Bib.
I'm yawning. Time for another drink.
It is necessary for human evolution that the individual should work with the spirit of sacrifice in favor of the common good. We should not be influenced by the terrible opinions of those idiots who pretend to know better than theme.
Bob.
I'm gonna say Bob.
Could be a Nazi.
That could be a Nazi, yeah. We've had a lot of Bobs recently.
It's
like,
too hard.
It can't all be Bob, surely.
Like, it's getting indistinguishable.
The individual...
many of these.
Guys, can we get something in the chat other than Bob? I'd like to see that right now.
I'm gonna go with Nazi for this one.
I want the Bob counter
Bob count.
That would be so high. It's got to be implemented after the stream as well, because if it was during the stream, then people would just say Bob on purpose.
Mm-hmm. Oh, Longshanks reckons it's a Nazi. What are you guys, everyone voting for?
So, Bob?
I don't know.
You know, spirit of sacrifice in favor of the common good? I feel like that's not something Bob would
Nazi.
Say.
Yeah,
whoa,
I think it's Nazi.
Common good, that's Nazi. Sorry, I didn't get that part.
Alright, yeah, I guess Nazis have it. Is it okay to dehumanize people because they are theme? Did we forget this at some point?
Bob.
Did they not have theme when growing up? Oh, it is okay
to
dehumanize.
Bob might be talking about women.
I think it's Bob, yeah, and he could be talking about all kinds of things.
I don't think a Nazi would use the word dehumanize.
I feel like a Bob would dehumanize right. somebody for, like, cutting in line.
Right.
You fucking troglodyte. Stop treating these theme like people. Theme are not redeemable and not worth redeeming in the first place. They are the justly forgotten remnants of an inferior world that we've evolved beyond and escaped. That's gotta be Bob, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
There are only two possibilities for theme. People won't choose the party of compromises forever. There can be no compromise. There are only two possibilities. Either victory for us or annihilation of the future and the victory for them. Theme,
I heard
sorry.
Us. That's Bob. That's not Bob. Sorry.
I think that's a Nazi, yeah.
Yeah, I think this one's Nazi.
Mm-hmm.
Fair enough. There can be no unprovoked violence against a theme. The sole aim and focus of their philosophical existence is violence. If you take up that identity, you've already declared violent intent. Anything done in response is just varying levels of self-defense.
That would be Bob.
Bob.
I don't think Nazis believe that, like, Jews are inherently violent.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know,
I guess it could be about Muslims.
Still going with Bob.
What do you reckon, Rags?
Mm. I'm going to go with Nazi on this one.
I see it being Nazi. I'm either way.
Bearing limit. I could see it as being both. I'm going to leave it with Bob. I have a feeling he's referring to Republicans and maybe healthcare.
Fuck, dude, this is actually what it feels like to take an exam.
Yeah, I know, right? all of our homework was watching MovieBob videos.
I see why he didn't prepare.
Morals are made up by addled old men who think they can talk to clouds and value is subjective. We should prefer knowledge, wisdom,
Bob.
And wisdom too.
Yeah, Bob, the
Bob
Nazis
would,
wouldn't say talking to clouds. That's a
Bob. Bob, Bob would, it's because he said old
Nazis
men. Bob demonizes old men.
But he's...
Yeah, he does.
He's gonna get up there eventually.
Nazis wouldn't specify men, though.
I joined the theme party because I'm a revolutionary, not because of any ideological nonsense.
Nazi?
Yeah.
Nazi.
Money stinks of capitalist democracy. Money has made slaves of us. Money is the curse of mankind. It destroys everything great and good. Every dollar is sticky with sweat and blood.
Nazi. I'm gonna say Nazi.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Did you know that Nazis are socialists?
Yeah.
All right.
But the thing too, he just seemed like he cared about a collective, which once again, Bob would never do.
Lenin is the greatest man, second only to Hitler, and that the difference between communism and Hitler's ideology is very small.
Nazi.
It's Nazi.
I mean, Nazi. I was going to say, maybe this one wasn't, this one's supposed to have themes, maybe.
Someone just said... Someone in the chat just said Bobbert Frick.
Bobbert Frick. Oh, Jesus. Somebody get... Well, you know, we got to see it in memes now.
We need to redefine the concept of democracy so that people of intelligence and reason can step in when theme make a bad decision.
That's Bob.
I would guess Bob on that one. Yeah. Conspiracy theories are absurd and childish, but they demonstrate that the entire concept of democracy is stupid because the great masses of people will believe any sort of total gibberish if it makes them feel good.
I'm gonna say Bob on that one.
Yeah.
I would go with Bob myself, yeah.
Oh, it could be a Nazi, though.
Well, that's the point of this whole thing.
One or the other here, of course it could. Thank you, J-Man.
Fortunately, demographics are squeezing these people out of having a say. It's just not happening fast enough. If we don't do something, they will mess it up for us before they can be removed and rendered irrelevant. I would say this, but he's got Bob. People in that's quotation Bob. Marks. It's got to be Bob.
Right.
Oh, that's absolutely Bob. Bob. That's all that I'm it being Bob for me.
Cyberpunk 2077 appears to be a full Nazi game. These are the same people who did the Witcher series, which was based on Polish mythology and basically a Nazi game.
What? I don't even know where to put that in general.
I guess that's Bob.
Oh, that could be anything.
That could be that,
Nazis think, are like, yay, it's though? A Nazi game.
Exactly. That could have been a disparaging term or an encouraging one. So
I think it's Bob.
I'm gonna abstain. I have no fucking clue.
I just Bob. Say Nazi just because.
Okay, I'm gonna say Nazi.
We got two Nazis, Nazi, one Bob. Then.
There wasn't enough disgust in there for the Nazi mentions.
I don't know. That could be an inflection thing.
Chat, as a change of events, seems to believe it's Bob.
What, really?
Look, a minute or two ago, they were going. Decided one is a Nazi.
I'm going with Nazi. I'm sticking with Nazi on this one.
It does seem odd. Like, if I saw him tweet that, I would be confused for a while, but that kind of is the experience of looking at Bob's tweets a lot of the time.
Yeah, that makes it more likely to be him.
A full Nazi game. These are the same people who did the Witcher series, which is based... I think Bob. Who were Bob?
I think it was 2-2.
Okay. Yeah, I think this is Bob.
I think it's because you know how, like, you're less understanding of an ideology. I think Nazis would understand Nazism well enough to know that Cyberpunk 2077 isn't a Nazi game.
Yeah.
The other thing I worry about is whether or not Richard Spencer is trolling in this one. It's just to make people upset?
It'll be interesting to find out some of these, I guess. I'm being as calm and decent as I can under the circumstances, but I'm as close to my last straw as I can get with trying to see redeemability in the worst of humanity. Bob?
That's probably Bob.
Election night, maybe?
That's Bob.
Bob on election night.
The rehabilitation of terrible people is a nice thought, but it's grounded in concepts of empathy that are often misplaced and the increasingly outdated prospect that broken bad eggs can be reconfigured to perform some
socially
useful. I know, I More fucked up. I'm
concerned about sociality, and there was not a period sociality. For a while.
See? Which, you know, there's loads of words you could invent when you look at that one, I swear.
Exactly.
I might be very tired, but I'm fine. I can totally... You can't have my keys. Wait, so what do we vote for this one? Bob?
Oh, yeah, going with Bob on that one.
I guess everyone said Bob, yeah.
I found that a closed fist to... Oh, sorry. Wait. Oh, it is that. I found that a closed fist to be a solid place to start. It's a bit clunky. But there is plenty of variety beyond that. At the end of the day, there are just bones and meat, and sufficiently cowed most will stifle before you have to break any of that.
God. Yeah, it sounds pretty Bobby.
This is a Bob one.
I could be a Nazi.
I feel Nazi on this one.
I think this is Bob.
I swear I saw this on Twitter at some point.
If it was a Bob tweet, they would have fixed the grammar.
Bob fixed something? That would imply you made a mistake. No.
The author of this quiz said they'd fix... But, well, it's
fine.
Oh,
the author of the quiz. Okay.
Wait, so how many people go in Bob again? It was three. Was it two?
So I'm going... I'm going Bob.
Nazi.
I'm Nazi as well, so that's three Nazis.
Really? Okay.
Democracy.
Nazis on EFAP.
Yeah, I know.
Nice.
Democracy is a failed system because the masses are not capable of making informed decisions about. I already want to say Bob.
Yeah, me too.
Bob. Socialism isn't the problem. It has a problem, namely that its primary proponents are theme.
Socialism has a problem. Hmm.
And its primary proponents are surely. Oh, I don't know.
Well, they're both... I don't know if Bob is a socialist. Nazis are socialists, apparently.
Mm-hmm. Right.
I don't think neo-Nazis are...
Of course.
And it seems to me that they, like, Nazis wouldn't really bring up the weaknesses of socialism.
Unless they were trying to make it into a particular group of people with a problem. Right?
Maybe.
I'm fully just coin flip on this one.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going with Bob on this one.
Oh, that's a tough one.
I say Nazi.
I was going to go with Nazi myself.
I fucking hate Nazis, man.
Rags, Jay, are you both abstaining?
Yeah.
Rags' silence tells me everything I need to know.
I just don't know.
It's thinking.
Is it the duty of properly evolved humans to prove that we are not theme or the worthless trash people who support them?
Bob.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
We though. Mm.
No, Bob. I think Bob has used the word we.
Okay, hang on. Say that one more time. It kind of got a little jumbled.
It is the duty of properly evolved humans to prove that we are not theme or the worthless trash people who support them.
You feel like it could be a Nazi.
I think that's Bob.
I feel like worthless trash people is a more modern. Well, I don't know. I gotta go with Bob.
Yep, Bob.
Yeah.
All right. The argument could be made that the theme vision of progress, rooted so heavily in romantic idealization, the pre-mechanization / pre-digital working class, is itself somewhat dated and hardly revolutionary anymore. I'm not really married to this idea. My revolution is my own.
I think it's Nazi.
I think I'm more toward Nazi than I am to Bob on this one.
Kind of have to agree there.
Yeah.
We'll stick with Bob. Yeah. I mean, Nazi, sorry. We'll stick with Nazi. was that a Freudian slip? And you're like, of course it was. What else would it be? At some point, it has to become all right to admit that there are too many human beings at this point. People think that it is wrong to propose a solution to this problem, but this every life is sacred belief is bullshit. Oh.
Nazi.
I yeah. thought it was a Nazi.
Oh, Bob.
I was going to say, I thought it was a Nazi right up until he Thanos'd at the end, and I was like, oh no.
I think Bob is too smart to actually talk about killing people in viable.
But he said he would with the Thanos glove.
Yeah, I don't think less people is a Nazi thing. Especially if it's their people.
Yeah,
but
the
thing with Bob, though, is he wants less people for sure, but specific ones. He wants to get rid of, you know. So I think this is applicable to him.
Let me check the chat. Yeah, it's Bob.
The main thing that the right has in common with the left is the appeal to losing end of progress. Real progress, societal evolution to a better future, offers those with it ascendance. I think that's supposed to be those with it. Offers those with it ascendance beyond obsolete tradition. Those who don't measure up retreat into bitter envy.
I don't even know what that means.
I think Nazi.
Bob.
Oh, I was thinking Nazi.
I think that's Nazi.
Rags, that's bullshit.
Gonna go fuck.
Ooh.
Yeah, maybe.
Let me in. I'm trying to fuck.
That's a reference to Thingaman, DJ Man, isn't
okay,
it?
Okay, I'm sorry to keep making you do this. One more time, please.
Wow, can you just pull the stream up at this point? We'll take that as a no.
Yeah,
that's a no.
That is the newest one. My only thing going with that is just that there's just no big sort of giveaway that it's a Bob to me.
Nazi.
I mean, he could say it, but I think a Nazi said it.
Someone in chat just added me. You're like, hey, some of these are my quotes. Copy strike.
All right, I'm gonna go with Nazi on this one.
Yeah, sure.
The Nazis have it.
Just the future. Leave me be.
The future belongs to those with the imagination and will to think and act on a planetary scale. The dialectic isn't nationalism versus globalism. Obviously, the nationalists will lose, and it won't be close. The question is what kind of globalist will determine the future of life on this planet. The battle has always been theme versus theme.
Bob.
I think Bob, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Because I assume in Bob's universe where everybody's uploading their consciousness to creepy robots or whatever on Mars, he would assume that it's a global faction of Earth at that point, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, in the future, ideally, Earth is much more united under whatever he believes that the perfect ideal humanity is.
United under Bob.
In Bob we trust, right? I'm not a communist precisely because it's proven untenable, but it's a morally and intellectually sound philosophy on paper.
Okay. That would be Bob. I don't think a Nazi would ever speak well of communism.
Yeah, I was going to say, how would it work with a Nazi saying that, I guess? But Bob, sure. I could totally say that.
Sure.
At some point, we need to stop treating stupid as functionally different from evil. Oh my god.
I think
this is Bob, yeah.
It's funny that... It's so funny that he's got that as a quote when that was kind of our conversation earlier, but in a slightly different way, right? Like, crazy versus, versus, like, whether or not it's well-reasoned or mentally ill. He's got someone being unintelligent enough to not recognize maybe X, Y, and Z is no different than evil. It's like, whoa. Fucking kids. They're all evil. Fuck them. Kill them. Benefit of the doubt, Bob. Jeez.
Fucking kids. Ew.
This is the world you get when a plurality of your population is not only ignorant and culturally unevolved, but proud to be so.
Exactly like a zombie pigman.
The irony is that the troglodytes voting for and supporting the theme won't be saved by them. I feel like that's Bob.
That's Bob.
I've seen him use troglodyte before. Troglodytes
again, yeah.
Yeah, I think so.
Overpopulation / too many stupid people is not eugenics. Eugenics is a terrible solution to overpopulation.
Bob.
Too many stupid people. I would 100% believe that he thinks he's like the top echelon of intelligence.
He really does.
Few things are genuinely better for your ego than realizing those aligned against your irrelevant themes. I've learned to process this as proof of my validity of my beliefs.
I don't know.
I'm gonna go with Nazi.
I'm gonna say Nazi.
I'm gonna say Bob. I'm gonna go against the waves on this one. I have a feeling it's Bob.
It's only one wave.
Yeah. Boberto, I think.
Jay with the... Oh my god, the Bobs have it! only five left. There is no meaningful far-left, far-right conflict in the US. What happened at Berkeley is a gang of theme attacking innocents whom recognize as their betters.
Nazi.
That's Nazi.
Mm-hmm.
I sympathize with the desire to be bent by empathy for the theme. I had the same weakness once. Understanding that their inability to be fixed was a failure of theirs and not mine was one of the most freeing experiences of my life. Bob?
Bob.
Yeah, Bob.
Yeah, I guess. I don't know. But, three, so it's Bob.
At the end of the day, the theme era is a solid reminder that institutions are only worthwhile until they aren't. Then you throw them out and replace them with superior ones. The better Americans deserve a better America.
Bob.
That's...
I don't know, that could be a Nazi.
That could go either way for me.
Yeah, that could be a Nazi, because again, I don't think Bob has any interest in bettering anything.
Oh, no, he
just wants the things removed until, like, it's just...
Yeah, he wants...
No, he thinks he's going to make a better world.
Okay, it's Nazi.
Well, I think it's Nazi, yeah.
What's everyone else think?
I'm going to go with Nazi on that.
I think it was Bob, he would say the better, like, people deserve a better world, not a better America. Not sure.
Fair enough.
Yeah.
All this cheating and skullduggery to protect a failed, inferior version of America that's never been worth keeping on life support and won't be missed by anyone who matters when it's replaced. So much wasted energy.
I think
Babity!
Bob about the DNC, maybe?
Yeah.
Or, yeah, I don't know, maybe. But I think that's Bob. I'm not interested in parties. I'm interested in forward and backward. Evolution versus stagnation. Progress to the better future versus regression to the inferior past. Only two sides to any of that.
Nazi.
Nazi.
I thought Bob.
But it's really? Quite eloquent, though.
Yeah. Because he talks a lot about, like, what is moving forward and progressing This is the people who hold us back.
Yeah, I think holding, you know, holding back, yeah, holding back's more of a Bob thing.
So wait, do we get three Nazis and two Bobs, or?
Yes.
That sounds like that. So we got three Nazis and two Bobs? Sounds like an order somewhere.
That is the main reason why this kind of political activity is abhorrent to people of character and courage, while at the same time it attracts inferior people. For a people who is not willing to accept responsibility for his own actions, but is always seeking to blame someone else, if a leader comes from that lower class of politicians, the consequences will become obvious when they mess it up for the rest of us.
I think that's Nazi.
I feel like that's a really good one to end on, because
for the rest of us,
yeah, there's lots
like
of Bobisms in there.
Yeah.
But it also feels very Nazi.
Mm-hmm.
They all feel pretty Nazi.
By that you mean they all feel pretty Bobbish? That's what you're trying to say.
Pretty Bobby.
Should we? I don't know. I'm gonna abstain.
Yeah. Okay.
I'll say Nazi.
Yeah.
What did you say, Jay?
I said Nazi.
The Nazis already have it.
The Nazis have won.
Thanks for taking this epic quiz. If you have any suggestions, have any notes you think can work in the quiz, or notice any problems, let me know. Thank you, Adam Hilt, I suppose. I congratulate you on finishing this nightmare. You can see the percentages for your questions by clicking the previous responses after submitting your quiz.
This is the even more exciting part.
What score did we get?
We got 360 out of 500.
There were 500?
Well, it's five points per question.
Points.
All right. Yeah. Okay, so we didn't do super, super well then.
So now I want to see where
we did
got
them wrong.
Yeah, I want to see which ones were wrong.
Okay, well, I'll scan to the ones that were wrong, I suppose. Oh my god, we got loads right in the beginning. Holy fuck. Okay.
yeah, like, well, that's the thing. It's like, it had a good difficulty curve to it. Easy in the start, and then they got really hard later.
People who have no understanding of the political world around them have no right to criticize or complain about our superior future. That was from a Nazi, not Robert.
I
would have said Nazi on that one.
History likes to forget that theme often grow to assault true progress when the backward and mediocre feel left out.
Where did we guess that? We guessed
Nazi on that one.
Hmm. And that was Bob?
That was Bob.
Hmm.
Don't tell me to buy inferior products or hire less capable qualified... Oh my god, we were wrong on the one where hired qualified workers, because we said that can't be Bob.
That
was Bob.
Ah.
I have to admit, I'm scrolling past loads we got right. I love the idea that we got somebody right. That's funny. Trump has opened the door to nationalism in this country. Not American nationalism, but the white race. Once that door's fully swung open, you can't close it. We guess Bob, it was a Nazi.
Oh my.
Every time a fellow white person asks me if I want to be a minority in my own country, I tell them I'm already a minority in our country. Oh, we were right about that being Bob. Well, I can't remember who voted what, but I remember us discussing about that being potentially Bob. So,
sure.
But we went with Nazi. Yeah. The answer was Bob.
No, I said Bob on that one. That was me. I was the odd one out.
I could have sworn I remember saying that I could see him. I remember I was being corrected about the way Bob would do it. Like, I said something like, yeah, he probably would say, I think I said he would say, you know, we are the minority already, to like a white person trying to make it sound like a bad thing. And then the counter was that he wouldn't see them as a grouping at all, because he hates them. They're less than, than him. But yeah, that was a good one, because, you know, there's reason to assume. So the one about Joker being a love letter to a mass shooter, we guessed Bob, it was a Nazi.
Oh, okay.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Interesting.
The nation I love and thought was heading in the right direction is failing, and we can only blame the ignorance of my fellow countrymen. We guessed Nazi, the correct answer was Bob. I feel like I would have gone with Bob on that one.
Yeah,
I think it was countrymen that kind of threw us off.
Oh, countrymen, yeah, you're right. That really
yeah,
did.
So that was Bob?
That was Bob. Oh wait, there's feedback. Someone just said read the feedback. What is the feedback?
Those are the comments right below it.
Oh, I guess this is where they sourced from the answers, I suppose. Yeah. This quote is from a review of the Joker on the Daily Stormer. Okay. The nation I love and thought. Oh wait, that's MovieBob is scaring me. The fact that no one wants to hear this... Sorry, I read this wrong again, because the fact that no one wants to hear is... The fact that no one wants to hear is... Like, it's fucking... There's no punctuation that helps me here. not everyone gets to win, even if you yourself aren't a theme. Theme is the superior way forward. We said that was a Nazi and it was Bob.
Oh.
I can't believe that answer. Like, is it? I think it
was one that we were kind of stuck on.
In those days, I was stupid enough to try and enlighten Theme about the meaninglessness of their beliefs. I thought I could show them the danger of Theme, but I was getting the opposite result. We thought Bob, it was a Nazi.
Huh. Hmm.
The feedback is sounds too understanding to be Movie Bob. It's very complicated, you know?
See, I swear I guessed Nazi on that one.
Huh. Theme cannot be won over, saved, or reasoned with. They need to be defeated along with their values and political power. We guessed Nazi, it was Movie Bob. I think those ones are the funny ones when we guess a quote was from a Nazi because it's so like extreme, whatever. No, it was Bob. Yes, I condemn democracy as it currently exists in the country, which is, quite anachronistically, still called by the name United States of America. We thought that was Bob, it was a Nazi.
Hmm.
Reading, and the feedback says, reading Nazi articles to find these quotes is really funny. They have so many Tismy quotes. Like, yeah. And yet some of them, you know, managed to sneak in with Bob. Within my lifetime, yep. One of these theme are going to make my... Wait, are going to make their own country, institute basically socialism to streamline the economy and act like they invented something totally new. We thought Nazis, it was Bob.
Damn!
And the feedback says moopishly.
Oh, well.
Moopishly.
Theme and theme represent two distinctly divergent
irreconcilable?
Yeah, I keep tripping up on that word. Irreconcilable paths of societal development, and they are in conflict. One will defeat the other, and there will either be a future for Theme, or there will not. We thought Nazi, it was Bob.
God damn it!
Resistance is futile. Movie Bob is the future, and he is here now. Surrender now, he will outvote you with his massive weight that comprises his being. Yes, ma'am.
Epically.
Right. Some of the most dishonest people can be identified by the use of the phrase, war never solved anything. Of course it does. If they were honest, they would say, theme never solves problems. We thought Nazi, it was Bob. Wow.
Holy shit.
The feedback says, okay, Robert.
that one's a surprise to me.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Marriage must indeed be refounded on the much more radical level than that imagined by the egalitarian religious right and constitutionalists. We thought, Bob, it was a Nazi.
Yeah, doesn't surprise me at all.
EFAP needs more loud soup memes. Agreed. The only reason to fear theme is if you are a weak or worthless person who can only hope to hold social power by a theme. A truly superior individual will not resist an evolving world. We thought Nazi, the correct was Movie Bob. I feel like on Movie Bob's team for that one. Whenever evolving comes up and superior, I'm always like, oh, it's such a Bob thing.
That's also a pretty Nazi thing, though.
Yeah. But, I mean, that's the point of this quiz. I'm just going to keep coming back to that. That's my final argument. It makes sense that we've gotten so many of these right and wrong. The US is only going to stagnate until people get on board with the idea that theme is a mindset place, demographic needs to be aggressively beaten, constrained, and negated to the point of... erasure by any means necessary. We thought Nazi, it was Bob. That's pretty amazing.
There you go.
Yeah. We got a whole bunch right there.
It'd be good if we had the told a theme.
Oh, hang on, you're breaking up a bunch. Try again.
It would be cool if when we actually got the answers, it told us what theme actually was.
Oh yeah, that'd be nice.
Oh, I guess so, yeah. Conspiracy theories are absurd and childish, but they demonstrate that the entire concept of democracy is stupid because the great masses of people will believe any sort of total gibberish if it makes them feel good. We thought, Movie Bob, it was a Nazi.
Oh, no.
Okay. Nope.
And the Cyberpunk 2020 being a Nazi game, we thought, Bob, it was a Nazi.
I knew it. That surprises me. Fucking knew it.
Even the feedback says, "How the fuck is this a Nazi quote?"
Wait, what was the quote? Sorry, what was the quote?
Cyberpunk 2077 appears to be a full Nazi game. These are the same people who did the Witcher series, which is based on Polish mythology and basically a Nazi game. It's like,
yeah. See, that's the thing. It's like there wasn't enough. Like, oh, I am clearly not in favor of Nazis. Like, work in that tweet or whatever that was to. Not to be MovieBob. It just wasn't enough.
I found that a closed fist... Oh, this is the one that's spelled organized weird. I found that a closed fist to be a solid place to start, but there is plenty of variety beyond that. At the end of the day, they are just bones and meat, and sufficiently cowed will stifle before you have to break any of that. Wow, we thought Nazi and it was MovieBob.
And I thought it was Bob!
MovieBob will break...
We thought it was a Nazi.
I swear that was in a tweet, so that's why I thought about that, yeah.
MovieBob will break your bones if you stand in the way of his superior future. Wow, exactly. I can't believe he said this.
Please arrest this man.
Like Bob said, at the end of the day, they are just bones and meat, and sufficiently cowed, most will stifle before you have to break any of that. What the hell?
Fucking, like, seriously, doesn't this count as threats to violence? Can't you legally arrest someone for this?
He said you won't even need to because they'll break before that, like, mentally. It's like, oh my god.
What a bad person.
Yeah, I think we can conclude that. Democracy is a failed system because the masses are not capable of making informed decisions about the way governments function. They are extremely susceptible to the technologies of advertisement which are used by the media to shape opinions and issues. We thought Bob, it was a Nazi. I think that was reasonable to assume it was Bob. Socialism isn't the problem, it has a problem. Namely, that its primary proponents are theme. We thought Nazi, it was Bob.
Mm-hmm.
Comrade Bob is the greatest Marxist
Comrade
of our time.
Color me surprised.
The argument could be made that the theme vision of progress rooted so heavily in romantic idealization, the pre-mechanization, pre-digital working class is itself somewhat dated and hardly revolutionary anymore. That way we thought Nazi, it was Bob.
That was my first thought because I thought I remember that tweet. I remember the tweet, but I was like, nah, it can't be.
Bob will page. The main thing that the right has in common with the left is that they appeal to losing end of progress. Real progress, societal evolution, and a better future offers those with it ascendance beyond obsolete tradition. Those who don't measure up retreat into bitter envy. We thought Nazi, it was Bob. That's my totally favorite agrees. Result, when we think it's a Nazi and it's Bob.
It's like the most common as well.
The future belongs to those with the imagination and will to think and act on a planetary scale. The dialectic isn't nationalism versus socialism, so that one. We voted Bob and it was a Nazi.
I guess a Nazi would think that it's not nationalism versus socialism.
There is no meaningful far-left, far-right conflict in the US. What happened at Berkeley is a gang of theme attacking innocents whom they recognize as their betters, their inheritors of a better post-theme American future. We thought Nazi, it was Bob.
Really?
Yeah.
Interesting.
At the end of the day, the theme era is a solid reminder that institutions are only worthwhile until they aren't. Then you throw them out and replace them with superior ones. The better Americans deserve a better America. We thought Nazi, it was Bob.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
Yeah.
Wow.
How about that?
This is certainly not the Bob's Not That Bad Guys stream.
And the last one we got wrong. I'm not interested in parties, I'm interested in forward and backward. Evolution versus stagnation. Progress to the better future versus regression to inferior past. Only two sides to any of that. We thought Nazi, it was Bob. I'm pretty sure I thought that was Bob for a while. Just the whole backward-forward progression thing. Like, it just feels like a Bob thing.
Yeah.
That's, that's been educational.
Hoo-wee!
Dude. What the fuck?
So if anyone ever asks why we're so harsh to MovieBob, because we can't tell the difference between him and Nazis. It's fucking hard.
So, we can't.
So you're saying, we got like 30% incorrect on that?
Yeah, we did pretty well considering we're Bob people. We've seen a lot of Bob stuff, but 360 out of 500, which would be what's 360 divided by 5, I guess?
Wait a minute, isn't that like more than half?
36, so it's definitely more than half. 36 out of 50, correct?
Yes.
That's 72%.
Oh yeah, that's a really obvious way to do it. High five. Yeah, we did pretty well then, right? That's like a passing grade.
Okay, yeah.
Yes, it is.
We didn't fail.
I didn't even study for that.
I know. I just love the top, right at the top of this is him and his stupid Mario cosplay. He's such a... He exists. I just want people to know this.
He exists.
Like, what a meme!